If somebody challenges your truth, if that upsets you, the secret is you're not as clear in your truth as you think you are. Because in my private practice, I work with all types of people from every religion that you can imagine, every spiritual path. And I even I trust in the divine to an extremely high degree, but I work with atheists as well. Because just because somebody doesn't believe, it doesn't challenge my belief at all. And whatever someone else's opinion is, they have the right to that opinion. And when you look at things like, here's the way I like to explain it with color. The color purple, which is my smallest bowl there, it's for the crown. Someone could say, well, that's an interesting shade of red. And I'd say, you're right. Well, that's an interesting shade of blue. You're right. Well, that's purple. You're right. See, that's the way a lot of things in life can be, is that somebody's just seeing something in a certain shade. And we get so upset and we allow them to upset us. See the shade however you see it. Let the others see it however they see it. Because here's another secret about helping people. The more you can stay in neutrality, the more likely you are to be able to assist somebody and change somebody's mind. As soon as you dig your heels in, it makes the other people dig their heels in. See, we're energetic beings and people pick up on these vibes. Even if they don't believe in energy or don't know about it, they still pick up on it. So I want everyone, tonight is going to be a journey through these chakras or these energy centers. And I'm going to go through and give a description of each one. But as we go through this evening, I want you to pay attention to where you carry tightness or discomfort. And if during this sound bath some emotion comes up, please release it. If you need to cough, please cough. If you need to sneeze, please sneeze. Because see, you holding that back for the courtesy of the rest of the group energetically interrupts more than the cough or the sneeze. So here we're going to respect everybody. But some of the things you've learned about manners, I'd ask you to set them to the side, because manners actually get in the way of consciousness. We've been trained so much to be not our authentic self and to put on a good show as much as possible. See, I think there's a way to be truthful and be honest and not bring people down. So there's some days that I just have what I call heavy days. I just get up and I'll feel some sadness in my chest. There's nothing intellectually connected to it. Most of the time I'm picking up on the overall consciousness, mass consciousness. And when that's there, I accept it. And I go, oh, heaviness, you're going to be with me today. I don't try to fix it. I don't try to get rid of it. I respect it. Then if I run into somebody and they say, Alexander, how are you doing today? See, we're taught to say good, great, fine. I might say, well, I feel kind of happily in an orange kind of world today. And that's what I get. I get a little chuckle. But they know what I'm talking about. I could say it sucks. See, that the vibe is different. So there's a way that you can be honest and true to your soul. Because see, when you say something that your soul don't agree with, it creates tension in the body. So this is why being authentic and being honest is so important. But be poetic, be creative with your words. You can change somebody's day by just being honest with them. Another one I like to say is, I brought a baseball bat to a football game today. Or I left and here it is snowing, I forgot to put my shoes on. So any way that you can come up creative to just show that there's a little bit of, you're not exactly in alignment today. But it doesn't have to be this heaviness. So emotional processing is one of the biggest parts of my private practice. I work to cry just about every single day. almost every single day. Because see, we have a physical level, a mental level, an energetic level, an emotional level, and a spiritual level. Those are our five levels of being. And all five of those are just as important as the other. So each one carries 20%. But our culture is stuck in the mental and the physical. But that spiritual, energetic, and emotional is what's running the show. So, why do I practice crying every day? Sometimes I cry to release. Sometimes I cry to gratitude about how divinely guided and amazing my life has been. And not because things have worked out the way I wanted to, because I've lost almost everybody important to me to death, including a wife 15 years ago. So I know death really well. But see, in every one of those losses, I took the time to learn what that loss meant to me, what that person brought to me, and how I could exemplify and honor them by bringing more of what they represented to me into my life. And so see, the reason I practice crying is I never want to be too far from it. See, the less we do it, the further we get away from it. That means we just stuff. And see, up till my wife passed in 2008, I was that tough guy. Never cried. Never showed no weakness, so to say. Now I'll challenge anybody on the planet to call me weak when I'm crying and releasing. Because it only takes about 30 to 45 seconds to do a proper emotional release. And you don't have to fly off the handle and become dysfunctional. Most of the time when I'm working with my clients and they can't release, I'm empathic, so I'll have a release for them and I will never stop talking. And in 30 seconds, it clears up. This is what I'm here to help people to see, that there's a beauty in these releases, both the so-called positive and the so-called negative. Does anyone have any questions so far? So, understand that any healing that any of you are going through, there are five levels of that healing. So, if you have a stomach issue, there's five things that you should be working with to expedite that healing. A broken wrist brings five messages. So here's the way that I look at wellness. It starts, every issue that we have as human beings, whether it be physical or emotional or even mental, begins from my perception and my just philosophy as a frequency-based philosophy, begins in the spiritual or religious realm. It starts with doubt. Something happens in our life where we don't think that it should be that way. We think that it should be another way. So see, the doubt then activates the mental level. The mental level is where the judge lives. Is this good or is this bad? We've been taught to choose one or the other. I don't dig it and I don't play that anymore. There is no good and bad. There just is. So when that judge at the mental level makes that judgment, it activates the emotional level, normally in a negative way. And then that emotional level, either through suppression or the over-exaggeration of it, weakens the energetic field or the aura that we have around us that Western medicine has proven exists. Good job, we're only a couple thousand years behind. And see, wherever that energy is weakened in a certain spot, it makes the physical body more vulnerable to injury and illness. So people can go try to take care of something physical, even have a surgery done, but if they don't work on the other four levels, it's likely to come back. So that's why I wanted to mention all of these different levels, and we're going to go through the chakras as well. So these chakras are energy centers. There's seven main ones. Normally I'll work with nine. I add one above the head and one below the feet. We actually have hundreds of chakras. But this is what most people are used to, is through the torso. And at the root, or the base of the spine, is the root chakra. And here's what I'm going to describe to do your best to remember little areas that you're already carrying some tightness or discomfort, because it could be associated to these issues. So the root chakra is around your safety, your security, your financial issues. So again, when people come to me in private sessions and they're complaining about lower back stuff that nobody can tell them what's going on, the very first thing I say is, why are you worried about money? A lot of people say, oh, not. They're kidding themselves because our culture taught us to worry about money. Buy your insurance, save for the future, do everything but live in the present moment. So that's why there's a lot of lower back and hip stuff going on with people. And the second chakra is just below the navel. And this is where our sexual energy and our creative energy reside. And the emotion of worry. So if you have digestive issues, consider how much you worry. Don't consider that you don't worry, because again, almost everyone worries to some extent. But some people are more chronic. So then the next one is the third chakra, or solar plexus, just below the rib cage. And this is where a balance between willpower and trust reside. And most people are out of balance on one of those. Some people are too trusting and they wait for life to come to them. Some people are too willful and just want to try to make everything that they want happen. And that's another reason in our culture that we have a lot of big bellies, because that willpower is the typical American way. You can have anything you want. You can be anything you want. The thing was, is they didn't teach you the cost. There's a cost to everything. So then the next one is the heart chakra. And this, of course, is where our emotional love is. Our unconditional love, I'll break off for a second, is measured at 528 hertz. And that's actually a C sharp. So I teach an advanced class in understanding unconditional love, because that's actually between the root and the second chakra. Because in order to carry unconditional love, you gotta feel safe and secure and not carry any financial issues, and you don't have any sexual issues that you're dealing with, and you're not worrying. So this is the emotional love. This is the unconditional love. So most of us have been hurt, and this is a big place that the heart chakra is one of the first places for people to shut down, and normally that starts as a kid. The majority of issues that every adult deals with normally get set up between the years of 0 and 7 years old. And then you live your life out of those reactions of the traumas that happened before your mind was completely developed. So the next one is the throat. And here it is imperative to speak your truth, people. Speak it to the wind, the sky, the trees, to Mother Earth. But it is not imperative to speak it to other people. When you do, just be prepared for opposition. Be clear in your truth, if it's important enough for you to say. And like I said, you should be willing to allow anybody else to have a challenging truth, and it shouldn't bother yours. Go high five. We see that different. What's the problem? So speak your truth. Speak it in your car. If you're at work and you had a confrontation with the boss, but you saved your job and didn't say anything, as soon as possible, get that out of exactly what you wanted to say, the way you wanted to say it. Get that vibration out. Same thing in social situations. We shouldn't vomit our emotions on other people, but if somebody does or says something that hits a chord, go get that out. Put it out on the energetic grid. The next one is the third eye. The third eye is here between the brows. This is where our computer gets bogged down, because we, most of us in our culture, have too many windows open, like in our computer, and it slows down the windows we have open. So that's why I'm a big fan of wisdom. Wisdom over intellect. Wisdom is about the emptying. The intellect is about the learning. We're intellectual culture. We've been so worried about work, learning so much to get the degrees, to get whatever you're searching for, to sound smart in social situations. But the key, beautiful people, is in release. Clean that plate before you try to put good food back on it. So that's why I said work to get comfortable with crying. And if anybody here has never been able to cry in front of somebody that knows how to hold space, see, there's two different kinds of crying. There's victim crying, which never ends. It never ends. You can cry for the rest of your life. And that comes with judgment. You or somebody else is judging while you're crying. But release cry is just that. You don't judge it. Nobody else judges it. If they do, you don't care. Like I said, if somebody judges me while I'm crying, high five, you don't understand. Again, it shouldn't bother my crying. It shouldn't go into any guilt. So, someone holding space for you, holding space is a non-judgmental arena. And to have a release in front of somebody like that is extremely invigorating. This happens almost every day in my private sessions. My room is the crying room because I'm comfortable with it. And most people aren't comfortable with crying. And they get judgment, they feel judged in their social circles or in their families when they do cry. That's very sad. So the next one is the crown. This is where we receive energy. Life force energy comes in our crown, goes through all our chakras optimally, and out our feet and back into the earth. It just creates a vortex like this. But almost everyone has blockages that keeps that flow from going all the way down. The mind is the biggest blockage for our culture. Say it gets past the mind, then anybody that's had heartbreak and hasn't dealt with it, it gets stuck here. So see, that life force for you to feel safe and secure and not worry about your finances. So that's why release work is so important. So much more important than putting information in from my standpoint. When I was 27, I got introduced to metaphysics. When I got introduced to metaphysics, I studied 8 hours a day, 7 days a week, while working full-time and raising a family. That's how much it turned me on. So for 10 years, I did that much studying. And now for 12 years, I haven't read a book. 12 years, because I've been applying what I studied for 10 years. So make sure that you're doing both, because the doing is more important than the studying. The doing. Lots of you know a lot of stuff, but make sure you're doing, you're utilizing. So, any questions at this point?
Oh, just for a little bit of the energy body, could you tell us a little bit more, please?
Yes, the energy body is very sensitive to the environment. So if you ever get around someone or a room or home that you just don't get a good vibe about, so you should learn to trust that. That's where our sensing or our intuition can reside, is in that energy field. And so I've learned to trust energy way more than people. When people have asked me, Alexander, why did you ever want to get into this field? I said, well, I've always worn my heart on my sleeve, and I got tired of people stomping on it. And when I learned to read people's aura, I don't care what they say. Energy don't lie. So I learned to watch people's bodies. The body says a lot more than the mouth does by how they're holding the body. Here's a key that I'm going to give you. This is one of my favorite secrets. Pay attention to the eyebrows when you're talking to somebody. When the eyebrows drop down, they're not receiving. When the eyebrows are up, they are receiving. So see, I watch people's faces when I'm talking to them, and if they even twitch down, I'll just say what I just said in another way. And I look for those eyebrows to go up. I don't even go, oh, did you understand me there? I just make the adjustment because I want to see people's eyebrows up when I'm talking to them. So just pay attention to that, because normally when the eyebrows go down, the chest comes out. And that means resistance. So look for that eyebrow up. Another key is when you are feeling emotional, maybe overly emotional, try looking up. Because if you'll notice, when you get emotionally negative, we look down. Our shoulders go in. It's this victim. So next time you're in that, try to look up. I like to use vocal toning, which is just elongated vowel sounds. Ooh. If you look up and do 8 to 10 of those tonings, I can almost guarantee your vibe will shift. It shifts your heart rate, your mental capacity, your energy. So try that next time that you feel overwhelmed, looking up and or using vocal timing. And the vowel sound doesn't matter. Great question about the energy field. Anyone else?
Thank you.
So, now we're going to get into just a little bit of what the rest of the evening is going to entail. I'm doing something different than I ever have before. At each one of these, I attempt to do something in that manner. And so tonight, I'm going to read you a poem that I wrote. And I want you to pay attention to how it spoke to you, whatever part stuck out as we go through it. And then you're going to go through your journey. And then I want to see if anything different comes through the journey or more. That's going to be a little bit of the interaction. We've got a pretty small group, so it makes it a little bit more intimate. So please don't be shy. People know that that we're all here for like-minded people. So you can't say anything or do anything wrong. I want to empower you with that. So after I get done reading the poem, then you'll get down into your positions, either sitting or lying. And then I will start low, and we'll go up and release it out. At the end tonight, I will hit some tinctures or some little bells together to let you know we're going into some quiet time. And we'll stay in that quiet time for just a few minutes, and then I'll strike them again, and then we'll begin our dialogue. So I did want to mention that I have a podcast. My partner, Aaron Keith, is here. He was helping with the smudging outside. We've been together for over 5 years. We have over 120, I think, or close to 120 episodes. So please check that out. It's at thewisewisepodcast.com. We have stickers up there. My private practice is very extensive. I do sound healing. I have a sound vibrational bed that relaxes you through frequencies. And then I do different energy types of energy work, adjustments, and the chakra alignment is one of my main things that I work with. Let's see here. Let's see be sure to, you know, follow me on any of the social media that you can find me on. That's a lot how I share this. We also have a mailing list if you really want to stay on top of everything. There's lots of classes coming very soon. And around the heart chakra time, there's going to be a couple people going around and misting essential oil. It's just lavender oil and with a few drops of lemon in it. Is there anyone that has any adverse effects from misting from essential oils? Anyone? And I got a little note here that I'm awesome, so I appreciate it. So now, anybody got any questions or comments? We're not in a rush here. We're all part of this talking is to bring everybody out of your busy day, your busy world, and just kind of getting everybody together. So I'm going to play a crystal bowl, and I want everyone to tone to whatever level you want.